so small. Do you think I matter at all?
I'm like this little person and I like to do things that make me feel big.
And I'm just naturally big.
When I look up into the starry sky, I think my, oh my, I get dizzy and weak, and it makes me think I have the lifespan of a fly. Can you see me?
We built the studio. I climbed inside the ceiling with a sledgehammer and knocked out our ceilings and raised them up high and used them to record screams and drums, and now we have
a really tall,
cool sounding room, acoustically designed completely by accident.
Drums are loud in here, aren't they?
My youth would be sealed in a can unreal, then I could be 12 feet tall.
Two worlds collided.
Two worlds collided at Belmont College. Somehow we ended up in the same recital rehearsal. He played bass and I was a background singer. And we became friends. One night in the car, I sang to John some of my melodies and some of my songs.
And the rest is history.
Yeah, we were together every day. Really, our friendship lasted quite a while before we ever got to the romantic part of it.
We quit school and moved to Grand Cayman to play in a band and wrote songs while we hung out in Grand Cayman, and it was really cool. And we did lots of scuba diving and got tans.
Are we gonna stay the way we are? Are we gonna break it all apart? Are we gonna make it when our love is tested? Are we gonna stay the way we are?
We'll have my mom sing with me, and that way we only have to do two tracks. We do the high harmony and the low harmony, and my mother and I blend so well, you really can't tell.
Well, when I was a young boy, I used to sit around with records of like Mahavishnu Orchestra and Pink Floyd and Moody Blues and Led Zeppelin and Beatles and all that stuff. And I would write down the like string arrangements and horn arrangements. I would write them down from listening to the albums. That's turned into a big part of what we do.
He can hear music in his head and write it down on a staff, you know.
Tap dance. I mean,
but I think this is like becoming a lost art, the whole art of string arranging and orchestrating.
I'm a dying breed.
I just love the book, John Steinbeck's book, The Pearl. What I read in the book, I identified with so strongly that I decided to go ahead, what the heck, I want to write a song about the book. Pizzicato strings at the beginning. I think that's really hooky, and that's John's cool thing that he came up with.
That one was probably the most fun to record, I think. Just because it has all the toys on it at once. And then getting to play horns more on this album was fun.
You like to eat your grits with butter, salt, and
playing a lot of percussion and playing theremin and playing the dulruba. And
the space phone.
The space phone.
Space phone's just a toy that...
Oh no, it's not a
toy.
In the wrong hands, I think it could be very dangerous.
Drummer is He's my brother. He's been with us almost as long as John and I have known each other and have worked on music. Sean has been a part of what we do. You have the prettiest
blue green eyes I've ever seen. Ben used to live in Nashville. Now that we're making records, we kind of just play on each other's albums now. So we just kind of roped him into coming in and visiting for a couple of days.
We've been on the road for a year and a half, or 2 years, playing every night on the road, and we get to come off of the road and put our studio together and like kind of live a normal life in our house.
We wanted the album to smell like our house.
Yeah, we wanted the album to. Yeah, we wanted it to smell like our house.
For better or for worse.
Yeah. It just kind of describes the way we are in the studio, as married people, as musicians, as writers. The making of the album was just what we did on a daily basis. Nothing was really forced. Recording has always been a part of our lives and what we do in our house. So it was very natural for us to do it, and we're really happy that the record label afforded us the opportunity to do it this way.